And we're back, everyone, to my Let's Play Fair series of Dragon Age Inquisition. So, the last fair was like an hour and 30 minutes of dialogues. And... Okay, then. Game's apparently being a bit slow to load. Whoops. No, I want to talk to her.
See reason, Lisette. We cannot stay here.
Why not?
Because we're Templars.
You're the one they're calling the Herald.
You don't sound happy about that.
I'm not. Your people have stood against everything the Chantry believes for years. I did not join the Order to adjust my faith so easily. But I appreciate what the Inquisition is trying to do, and your role in it. Though you may find not many Templars do. We're a distrustful lot by nature.
Investigate!
I'd like your take on the Templar Order.
It's a shadow of what it was. Where once we both protected all people from the dangers of magic, we now posture and grab at power. One day, I hope the circles are again sanctuaries where mages can practice their craft.
You're not going to rejoin the Order.
When the temple went up, your forces rescued those few of us still alive. My life is a debt I intend to repay, however I can.
How did you come to be a Templar?
It seemed the right thing to do. My family are tradesfolk in Denarim. I could have become a cobbler like my father, but this seemed better. It's a chance to uphold the Chantry's laws and help the mages through a troubled time.
I'm surprised to hear that.
Not all Templars want to make mages into prisoners or villains. Some of us just want to keep a balance and let you practice your craft in safety.
Yay, good Templars.
One person trying to do something can make a difference. You should keep that in mind, Herald.
Do you have any idea what caused the explosion?
No, I'm just a recruit. Belief and faith doesn't get you closer to the important meetings. Though that distance did save my life.
Huzzah.
I will talk to you later.
Walk in the Maker's grace.
Loot. Schematic. Schematics are good. Amulet of Cunning. It's also good. Because... Let's go over here for a second. Attribute. Cunning. The character's intelligence and deviousness. Each part increases critical chance. And critical chance is very useful. For pretty much any character. So yeah. Don't really care about the life ward ammo anyway. And then there's Colin and Cassandra and people swinging swords everywhere.
You there. There's a shield in your hand. Block with it. If this man were your enemy, you'd be dead. Lieutenant, don't hold back. The recruits must prepare for a real fight, not a practice one.
Yes, Commander.
We've received a number of recruits. Locals from Haven and some pilgrims. None made quite the entrance you did.
At least I got everyone's attention.
That you did. I was recruited to the Inquisition in Kirkwall myself. I was there during the Mage Uprising. I saw firsthand the devastation it caused.
Sir.
Cassandra sought a solution. When she offered me a position, I left the Templars to join
people are phasing it in and out of reality.
We face something far worse.
I must have this mark for a reason. It will work, I'm sure of it.
Provided we can secure aid, but I'm confident we can. The Chantry lost control of both Templars and Mages. Now they argue over a new divine while the breach remains. The Inquisition could act when the Chantry cannot. Our followers would be part of that. There's so much we can...
Forgive me. I doubt you came here for a lecture.
so we can flirt with him. Because that's a thing.
No, but if you have one prepared, I'd love to hear it.
Another time, perhaps.
Smug.
There's still a lot of work ahead.
Commander, Sir Raiden has a report on our supply lines.
As I was saying.
I wasn't done talking to you, though. There's a bot. There's a bot. What the armor spare for the fair?
Did you need something?
Sarah's again. Why are you forcing this on me this soon? Game.
Did you leave anyone behind in Kirkwall?
No. I fear I made few friends there, and my family's in Ferelden.
No one special caught your interest.
I can't say I was looking. Honestly, I was not good company back then.
why am I doing
enjoy
this?
Your company.
That's... I would value your friendship. I'm afraid I cannot offer more. I trust you'll understand.
Yeah, I'm not even sure why it's pretty... It's like, for some reason, you can romance Cohen this soon in the game. So much dialogue.
Is there anything I should know?
Not at present.
I'd like to know more about the Templars.
If you need insight into what the Order is doing now, I'm afraid I can't offer more than you already know. Anything else, I will answer as best I can.
Investigate. Oh, God.
Why did you join the Order?
I could think of no better calling than to protect those in need. I used to beg the Templars at our local chantry to teach me. At first, they merely humored me. I must have shown promise, or at least a willingness to learn. The Knight Captain spoke to my parents on my behalf. They agreed to send me for training. I was 13 when I left home.
13? That's still so young.
I wasn't the youngest there. Some children are promised to the Order at infancy. Still, I didn't take on full responsibilities until I was 18. The Order sees you trained and educated first.
What about your family? Did you miss them?
Of course, but there were many my age who felt the same. We learned to look out for one another.
Do the Templars do anything besides hunt mages?
Templars protect against the dangers of magic. Before the Order left the Chantry, that meant serving in a circle. They were also tasked with tracking apostates or fighting demons inevitably summoned by the weak or malicious.
What do you think of mages? Are they all a threat?
I've seen the suffering magic can inflict. I've treated mages with distrust because of it, at times without cause. That was unworthy of me. I will try not to do so here. Not that I want mages moving through our base completely unchecked.
I am a mage.
We need safeguards in place to protect people, including mages, from possession at the least.
You've lived in the circle. What was a typical day for a Templar there?
Typical? The last time I was in a circle was right before it fell apart. Nothing was typical.
Before that, then?
Certain rituals require a full guard. A mage's harrowing, for instance. I've attended a few. Most of the time, you merely maintain a presence, on patrol or in the circle, ready to respond if needed. Mages pretend to ignore that presence, but they're watching you just as closely.
The Templars and mages never speak to each other.
Some do, but Templars are supposed to maintain a certain distance from their charges. If a mage is possessed or uses blood magic, you must act quickly, without hesitation. Your judgment cannot be clouded. Of course, ignoring one another does nothing to foster understanding.
What is Templar training?
So much dialogue.
There is weapon and combat training. Even without their abilities, Templars are among the best warriors in Thedas. Initiates must also memorize portions of the Chant of Light, study history, and improve their mental focus.
Did you enjoy your training?
I wanted to learn everything. If I was giving my life to this, I would be the best Templar I could.
You were a model student.
I wanted to be. I wasn't always successful. Watching a candle burn down while reciting the Chant of Transfigurations wasn't the most exciting task. I admit, my mind sometimes wandered.
Do Templars take vows? I swear to the Maker to watch all the mages, that sort of thing.
There's a vigil first. You're meant to be at peace during that time, but your life is about to change. When it's over, you give yourself to a life of service. That's when you're given a filter, your first draft of Lyrium and its power. As Templars, we are not to seek wealth or acknowledgement. Our lives belong to the Maker and the path we have chosen.
I see.
That's all I wanted to know. Thank you.
No, that's not. Do you not understand? There's yes. More dialogue. We must expel all the dialogue.
I should get to know you better. We're working together after all.
What would you like to know?
All right. Where are you from?
What? I'm talking to Colin and our son. How'd that for Elden? Werewolves.
I grew up in Pharrell. What? I was transferred to Kirkwall shortly after the Blight. This is the first I've returned in almost 10 years.
The game's being odd.
You haven't seen Ferelden in 10 years. Are you glad to be back?
I was not sorry to leave at the time. I did not expect to return. Now, between the Divine's murder and the breach, I've arrived to find nothing but chaos.
You were in Ferelden during the Blight. Did you fight Darkspawn?
No. I was stationed at Ferelden's Circle Tower. The Circle had troubles of its own. I remained there during the Blight.
What happened at the Circle Tower?
Few who survived the Blight have fond memories of that time. I would prefer not to speak of it.
And there was a bunch of demons and an annoying fade puzzle thing. But yeah, fun times.
What was Kirkwall like?
While I was there, Canary occupied and then attacked the city. The Viscount's murder caused political unrest. Relations between mages and Templars fell apart. An apostate blew up the Chantry, and the Knight Commander went mad. Other than that, it was fine.
Alright.
What happened between Kirkwall's mages and Templars?
You were at the Conclave. I must have heard people speak of it.
Yes, but you were there.
There was tension between mages and Templars long before I arrived. Eventually, it reached a breaking point.
Dragon Age 2.
There was fighting in the streets. Abominations began killing both sides. It was a nightmare.
This game really does decent at explaining stuff from, like, Dragon Age 2 and Dragon Age Origins.
What happened then?
Templars should have restored order, but Red Lyrium had driven Knight Commander Meredith mad. She threatened to kill Kirkwall's champion, turned on her own men. I'm not sure how far she would have gone. Too far.
So you opposed her?
I stood with the champion against her, in the end. I should have seen through Meredith sooner.
Varric's from Kirkwall. Did you two know each other?
I knew he was friends with the champion of Kirkwall, but little else. We've spoken more since I joined the Inquisition, largely at Varric's insistence. Apparently, I spend too much time with a serious expression on my face, and it's bad for my health.
I see.
I'll let you return to your work.
More dialogue.
Yes.
Why would Templars break away from the Chantry?
The Order believes the Chantry no longer supports their efforts, not to the extent they should.
But the Templars have served the Chantry for ages.
And in that time, they've come to take the Order's services for granted. Templars risk their lives against blood magic, demons, abominations, to feel as if those efforts are dismissed. I may disagree with the Order's actions, and I'm here as proof of that, but I sympathize with their frustrations.
So good, ask about colleagues.
What do you think of the people you...
Who do you mean?
But, meh.
I should let you get back to work.
I meant to walk, but okay. Now then, Cassandra.
Ugh.
You're kind of a force of nature, aren't you?
When I need to be.
It's impressive.
You flatter me.
I'm trying.
Did I do the right thing? What I have set in motion here could destroy everything I have revered my whole life. One day they may write about me as a traitor, a madwoman, a fool, and they may be right.
What does your faith tell you?
I believe you are innocent. I believe more is going on here than we can see. And I believe no one else cares to do anything about it. They will stand in the fire and complain that it is hot. But is this the Maker's will? I can only guess.
You don't think I'm the Herald of Andraste?
I think you were sent to help us. I hope you were. But the Maker's help takes many forms. Sometimes it's difficult to discern who it truly benefits, or how.
You didn't have any choice.
Didn't I? My trainers always said, Cassandra, you are too brash. You must think before you act. I see what must be done, and I do it. I see no point in running around in circles like a dog chasing its tail. But I misjudged you in the beginning, did I not? I thought the answer was before me, clear as day. I cannot afford to be so careless again.
Can't say I'm not grateful to hear that.
I can be harsh, I know. You've said you don't believe you're chosen. Does that mean you also don't believe in the Maker?
I'm a canary.
You're asking me.
You're not a follower of the Kyun. You could be. I suppose it doesn't matter now. I have to believe we were put on this path for a reason, even if you do not. Now it simply remains to see where it leads us.
And now the dialogue ends, and after we talk to her. Because fun times. No. Why am I... But... Talk to her, dammit.
It occurs to me I don't actually know much about you.
Dialogue. Game.
What do you want to know?
There we go.
I'm... not sure. Where are you from?
Make something up, Tower. Yeah, Tower.
A specific place. My mercenary band worked mostly in the Free Marches, however.
At least until you crossed the Waking Sea to reach the Conclave, I suppose. Tell me, do you consider the Free Marches your home? Are you eager to go back?
Wherever I am is home enough for me.
That's how I feel now, after years of tending to business for the Divine.
Investigate.
I'd like to get to know you better.
You would?
Is that a problem?
Not entirely. I'm just curious as to your motivation.
No motivation beyond making things between us less...
antagonistic?
Exactly.
As you wish. My name is Cassandra Pentagast, daughter of the Royal House of Navarra, 78th in line for the Navarran throne. I joined the Seekers of Truth as a young woman, and was with the Order until they withdrew from the Chantry. I remained as the Divine's right hand, carrying out her order to form the Inquisition. And here we are. That's all there is to know, my lord.
You're a member of Navarra's royal family.
The Pentagasts are a very large clan. Half of Cumberland could say the same.
Really?
No, but it feels that way. I have hundreds of relatives so distant they need charts to prove we're related at all. And they have them. Oh, yes. The Pentagasts value their precious blood like it runs with gold.
And you joined the Seekers to get away from that?
It was a life worth getting away from. The Pentagasts are famed for dragon hunting, but few actually pursue the craft. Most are fat and lazy. They pay lip service to the Maker and care only for idle pleasures and past glories. My brother was all that kept me in Navarra. Once he was gone, so was I.
Well, then we could try to do this one, but she's going to deny such.
I would prefer not to speak of Antony. Another time, perhaps.
Understandable.
You don't.
Also, very sacrificing. We.
Gilded cage. My uncle treated me like a porcelain doll to be placed on a shelf and dusted only when necessary. Thus, I did not see Navarra. The real Navarra until much later. By then, I realized I knew it not at all.
Your uncle? What about your parents?
They had the misfortune of taking the wrong side in the second attempt to overthrow King Marcus. The king executed them, but spared my brother and I since we were family and children at the time. Thus we were raised by my uncle, a mortaletasi who preferred the company of his corpses to the living.
Your uncle was a mortaletasi?
A death mage. He still is. My countrymen do not burn the dead, they bury them in special crypts. The mortaletasi supervise the crypts, like priests. Uncle Vestalus oversees the Grand Necropolis. Navarans spend more time honoring dead relatives than they do with living ones. It is odd to be so fascinated with death and its trappings. I will never understand it.
So you were the right hand to the Divine?
To Divine Justinia, yes. And Divine Beatrix before her, in fact. The position is normally reserved for Templars of the Knights Divine, but my circumstances were unusual.
Unusual how?
You don't know the story? Thank the Maker. I will tell you if you wish, but it isn't as exciting as some drum it up to be. The short version is that I once saved the previous Divine's life. My reward was becoming her right hand.
But what does a right hand do exactly?
What is your hand capable of? It gives, it takes, it beckons. It makes a fist. Liliana and I extended the Divine's reach beyond the Grand Cathedral. We went where she could not. After Beatrix, I was tired of the position and wanted to return to the Seekers. But Justinia convinced me to stay. Her vision for the future gave me hope.
You thought she could really change things?
Justinia knew the war was coming long before it began. She tried to avert it, but the forces arrayed against her were too strong. Sometimes you have to break a bone so it can be reset. That's where the Inquisition comes in. It was to be the answer. A means to preserve as well as an agent for change. I only wish she had lived to see it.
I'll let you get back to work.
Oh, more dialogue. I said more dialogue.
Can you tell me more about the Seekers?
The Seekers of Truth were born from the original Inquisition long ago, when it united with the Chantry. Seekers stood above the Templars, watching over them but also investigating magical events they couldn't handle. We were meant to be incorruptible, above reproach. How seldom does reality match the ideal?
But what are Seekers exactly?
Those who know anything of us think we are Templars. We do not use lyrium, however. Our abilities are different, as was our original purpose. We disciplined the Templars and were accountable only to the Divine. And not even her, truthfully.
So the Seekers commanded the Templars?
No. The Order didn't assume command until after the rebellion. The Templars have always feared us. When a Seeker arrived at a circle, they knew trouble was afoot. That kind of power is troubling. You begin to think you are the only one who can solve the world's problems. If you don't see a problem, it doesn't exist. If someone insists it does, they are the blind ones.
Do you think that kind of problem could ever be fixed?
Possibly. Though the Seekers themselves would need to change. They were clearly not willing to, even though they abandoned everything they stood for to avoid it. In my heart, I believe they can still be salvaged, but not by their own hands.
You mentioned that Seekers have different abilities than Templars.
Entirely. A Templar's abilities come from Lyrium and are designed to hunt mages. Ours come from ritual and many years of dedicated training. We cannot be possessed by demons and are immune to mind control. Useful, considering our role. Seekers can gain other gifts, though that depends on the individual.
What kind of gifts do you have?
I can set the Lyrium within a person's blood aflame. Both mages and Templars bend before my will.
Well, that sounds dangerous.
Some Seekers use it to interrogate, others simply to paralyze. Once there was a Seeker who could use it to kill. That particular gift is considered rare.
Why did your order turn against the Chantry?
We originally united with the Chantry through a treaty that stated they would keep mages under control. It was felt Most Holy had tacitly allowed the Circle of Magi to vote on its independence, thus breaking the treaty. The Seekers saw themselves as justified, and they led the Templars into a war of righteousness.
You sound like you disagree.
We knew what was happening at Kirkwall, where the Mage Rebellion began. We looked into reports of Knight Commander Meredith's harsh treatment of her charges years earlier. But we found so many shocking cases of magical corruption, it was decided her actions were justified. If we'd been there when it happened, if we'd looked harder at the root causes,
what happened couldn't be avoided. It started long ago.
We weren't helpless. We had the power to act and chose not to. When faced with a problem, the Seekers would close ranks and crush it. We would find an answer, but only once we felt we weren't being coerced. The moment the mages voted for independence, our response was predictable. It was difficult to watch.
How does someone become a Seeker?
Most Seekers begin training in their youth. I was much older, an exception due to my noble birth. We train rigorously for years. Our bodies and minds must be elastic to undergo the vigil, and most fail even then.
Is the vigil some kind of initiation?
It is the rite every Seeker must go through in order to summon their gifts. A full year of fasting, prayer, and separation from all distractions, including other people. We empty ourselves of all emotion, focusing only on the purity of our devotion. And the moment it finally ends, it's wonderful. Faith realized. I cannot put it into words.
Was it some kind of magic?
I don't fully understand it, to be honest. If the vigil was not so arduous, I'd say more should attempt it. What if mages never needed to fear possession by demons? I'm told it is impossible, however. I suppose I'll never know the truth of it now.
I have no more questions.
Yes?
I have no more questions. I have so many questions. I guess I should.
I have some more questions.
Why am I not surprised?
So what's the story about you becoming the right hand?
Sweet Andraste, do you really want to hear that?
Yes.
It was what, 18, 20 years ago? Some still discuss it like it happened yesterday. The tale gets bigger each time it's told. I barely recognize myself within it now.
I'm sure you're just being modest.
I was there. I think I know what happened. To hear others tell it, I alone saved Divine Beatrix from a horde of dragons sent to assault the Grand Cathedral. Rather impressive for such a young seeker, wouldn't you say?
And the truth is?
I stumbled upon a conspiracy to kill Beatrix. A Templar Knight Commander was at its heart. And there was a dragon battle at the Grand Cathedral. But I had help from loyal mages who rallied to the cause. They freed the dragons from magical control. Without them, the Divine and I would both have died. Yet I became the right hand, and they are forgotten.
You're delightful, you know that?
No, I do not know that.
Mm-hmm.
I object. There is nothing delightful about me.
I beg to differ.
I think I preferred you in the stocks.
Okay. But still one more dialogue tree to go through.
May I ask you about the Chantry?
It is difficult to say what becomes of the Chantry now. They have no Templars, no leadership, and no one left who is worthy of succeeding the Divine. It has fallen apart when everyone needs it the most. I ache to think what this will mean in the days to come.
Dialogues. Anyway, who is that douchebag?
What influence does Chancellor Roderick really wield?
He's a bureaucrat, responsible for communicating the Divine's will to the rest of the Chantry. Therefore, he's accustomed to the clerics hanging on his every word, hoping his influence will benefit them. Despite that, Roderick is not a bad man. He's frightened, and believes his place is to fill the gap left by Most Holy's death. Some might agree. As far down the chain of command as he is, there is no one left above him.
How big a problem could he be?
No more than he is already. He sent his message to the College of Clerics. That is the only card he had to play. Dealing with him further only lends him credibility he doesn't deserve.
Do you really believe the Chantry is worth preserving?
I do. Though I understand how someone born outside of human society might think otherwise. Cast the Chantry aside and new problems replace old ones. We will have learned nothing from history. The people need stability. And the Chantry needs a new purpose. Andraste had a dream for us. It can still be achieved.
So what should that new purpose be?
A dedication to what is truly important. Instead of building cathedrals and sewing gowns for the Divine, the Chantry used to spend its coin feeding the poor. If we are to spread the Maker's word across the world, we must do so with open hearts and open hands.
That sounds rather idealistic of you.
Does it? I do not think it's so unachievable. The Chantry has many good, honest people. They just need direction and inspiration. They need to be freed from centuries of adherence to tradition and ceremony. A chance for renewal is at our fingertips. It does not have to come with utter chaos.
Will the Chantry replace Divine Justinian?
They will try. Once the priests withdraw for the Grand Consensus, it is against Chantry law for them to emerge without naming a new Divine. Sometimes it takes days, or weeks, or even months. The problem now is that no clear successor to Justinia exists. All worthy clerics died with her at the Conclave.
So what happens if they can't agree on someone?
Theoretically, they will argue until exhaustion takes them or they see reason. Practically, however, if the Grand Consensus goes on too long, the Chantry will crumble. Any cleric with ambition but little sense will see this as her one chance, and plenty of such clerics exist. We shall see what happens. The Inquisition must act in the meantime.
If they do choose a new Divine, will you serve her?
That depends on whether she would have me. I am a rebel now, remember? And even if she would, I do not know. It would depend on what type of divine she is. I am no longer in a position to follow blindly, and no new divine could expect such obedience now.
I'm surprised you rebelled against the Chantry.
I left my own order when they took the wrong path. It is no different. But in neither case did I stop caring. Indeed, I care so much that I feel drastic action is necessary. I suppose history shall one day judge my actions.
Thank you.
Well, lots of dialogue.
When there was no Sky Maker, you were the sky. When there was
If the Inquisition wants to field a decent cavalry, it needs better.
Expected you'd be by. I'm Harrit, and everyone knows who you are. How's the new gear fit?
It doesn't really matter in the long run.
Of course it does. World's gone mad. Stock armor and blades are good against bandits, but we're not fighting bandits. My gear will see you through demons, apostates, whatever this world throws at you. So, you need custom work, something special. You bring the materials to us, we'll make it happen.
Can you help improve my arms and armor?
Yes. You find a new piece, a pauldron or greaves, we'll take care of you. You can't just slap a new hilt on your sword in the field. Bring it here, we'll make sure it's done right and proper.
If I want something, what can you make?
Start simple. Something to keep you safe. Take a look at it on the table there and we can talk. You'll need materials. We should have what you want just outside.
How did you come to be here?
Come from a little town called Lothring. Long gone now. I was in Redcliffe when the Darkspawn hit it during the Blight. Helped rebuild. Left when Rorty decided it was time to hand the place over to the bloody mages. Ended up here. Just missed the boom. Can't decide if I'm the luckiest son of a bitch walking or the exact opposite.
Sounds like someone has it in for you.
Don't I know it.
Who outfits the Inquisition soldiers?
Not me. I've got work to do. Can't be passing a sword to every blighter who signs up. If you want to help the troops, talk to Thren, the quartermaster. She'll set up requisitions.
What can you and your team make here?
Arms and armor. We work iron to blighted dragonbone, if you've got it. Our designs are simple, but they get the job done. Do you want something fancy? Bring your own design. We'll see what we can do.
Does the Inquisition not have supplies to make armor or weapons?
Tough convincing traders to haul up here. Impossible to get them to risk the rare stuff, so that's on you.
Goodbye.
Right.
Okay, so now then. I was thrown up just from talking to people. Stuff. Also, you could buy, sell, you could buy this. This is a respec amulet. It's useful. But a bit expensive. Buy that one, though. But I wonder, why did I buy that? Quite simple, actually, because no, not that tree. Long shot's good. Okay. That's better. Freaking cow drops. So, crafting. An apprentice coat. So here's how you craft. I basically take things like... No, go back. I don't care. I'm trying to... Okay. So basically you look at things. Like if we had silk, we could add more magic. Well... But we don't. So we have to deal with what we have. Let's say that. And now then for this. Magic defense, electrical resistance, spiritual resistance. Don't really have anything good, so we just have to use what we have. We have a healing apprentice coat. It's meh, but I'll have to do. We might give it to... Right. What's his face? Alright, modify armor. Modifications. We don't really have modifications yet. Except for... Well, that is that. It's too magic, which meh. Okay, so there's only one person who really has stuff that can be modified at the moment, which is Ferox Bianca, which you can usually buy stuff for it at certain merchants and such. But yeah. We can craft those things. But anyway, we can also make a staff, which... Honestly... It's meh. We don't have the resources yet. But we have leveled up. Which is good. So... Yeah, threat reduction. Always a good thing. Or to this bot. Maybe it has resources. Apprentice coat arms isn't bad, guys. You can use it to modify armor and get benefit from it. Eventually we'll be able to craft some decent stuff. Eventually. It's gonna be quite a while, though. Also, Nug. Which has Nug skin. We're going to be carrying a bunch of critters, just because leather. There's a place where I can get some really nice leather, and it's sort of mid-early game, too. There's a good way to make some money early on. But anyway, the good thing is we finally actually finished talking with people. Can you believe it? Woof. So now we can actually go about doing tutorial-y side quest, which is eh, but might as well. So basically we go out here and we loot everything we can find. Interesting, there's a lot of things we can find. That blue dot would be like a critter, like probably a Nug, if anything. It's a lot easier to kill those things as a mage. Because as a warrior, since you can't have your party members, you have to basically run after them, and they're faster than you, and it's tedious. The mage, though, all you have to do is point your staff and fire. And usually they die. Oh yeah. There's a decent bear veil fruit hill, and iron. And nugs, and... rams, I think. And some other things, too, I think. But anyway, there's a decent amount of resources here, basically. And we're going to want as much as we can carry. We also need to do the side quest here too. Monica's progress. Don't game, I know how to search.
I should look around.
So now then, there's a dingy noise, which indicates that you should probably go over here. Because you're looking for something hidden. Even though it's in plain sight. And now we got the notes we need. Now we need probably more resources. We always need more resources. Everroad is for potions. And we're going to need loads of Everroad for potions. Loads of Everroad for upgrading potions. Just loads of resources. Which eventually at the war table we can basically get missions where we can basically obtain resources. And with our exploit of how the war table works, we could basically do that for a while and get a decent amount of resources. Unless they fix that. I don't know, it's been a while since I've done this. And yeah, if they fit that, that's going to be annoying for Let's Play purposes. Also, my throat is really getting tired of all this talking I've done for this. Need to get back into the whole Let's Play status of fend by myself. I'll practice. Ram horn. So we can do more damage, be effective against rams. More. Not exactly ideal, but oh well. And here's that locking stand we need. I saw you run by. Why isn't it dead? If Sarah gets away, I'm gonna be annoyed. Alright, stop that.
Die!
So yeah, lots of elf fruit. It's gonna be a lot of resource gathering. I do some of it off camera, though. In the moment, I'm just showing basically stuff that goes on outside Haven. It's fun times. Now then, the Drephalodes actually fight back and they're armored. Jeez, are they armored. Been nice if I actually dropped lever. So Drephalo hide. They drop a decent amount of it. It's useful for rogue armor because of the dexterity. It's also useful because of the critical chance.
Ah!
Okay, I believe there was something else we're looking for. I think maybe not. Maybe we got everything. See, we got the requisition. We got the node. We got the logging stand. It might be good. But meh, might as well grab what resources there are. The resources do respawn, which is always good. As do the random animals. I'm not entirely sure what to talk about while farming things, you know. But Dreflos. I think I'll kill these two and then head back. And you can see why I like Energy Barrage. It does a decent amount of damage compared to my other spells. Oh, well, I'm smart. I'm just getting bold now. That's a, probably a decent amount of loot for now. Well, it probably isn't in the long run. But oh well, can't keep just farming here. The failures would get dull right off the bat. I will, however, do this. No, you're not getting away. More ram lever. Which is useful. But how useful? Eh, dexterity. Dexterity is always useful. And now let's head back. Because honestly, you could spend days just farming and not really get any well.
Oh, make her hear my cry.
I think she got the dialogue out of the way. For now.
Make her, though the darkness comes upon me. I shall embrace the light. I shall weather the storm. I shall endure.
The dialogue will be worse later on. That much is for certain. Okay, also, our main quest. Companion quest. Sort of side-ish quest. For areas we haven't gone to yet, havens we're working on. I visited the potion loadout thing. Maybe I didn't. Wait, what's this? Take a look on the bot before. Click on the bot. Nope. I can't click on the bot. Oh well. Talk.
Can I help you with something?
Oh, I have to actually fill the record position that over here. Right. Inquisition weapons craft. Our soldiers require additional weapons if they are to be effective. We get one power. Huzzah.
Excellent.
Now then, you.
What do dwarves do when magic gets out of control?
I'm listening.
Anything I should know?
I've nothing to report at the moment.
Right. Well, carry on then. Solus is just now appealed. I'm getting stuck on things.
Flissathor, you and your...
You're back. And in one piece.
Here you go.
You said you thought Master Tajan was working on something special. If it helps, I found his notes.
The old codger was on the edge of a breakthrough here, but he couldn't see it. You want some of these mixed up? You just give the word.
So we got Lyrium Potion, which isn't bad. Or secret potions. Now that Lyrium Potion increases magic by... But it's not bad, but we're going to want regeneration potions. The problem though is they cost Elfroot, and you have to give them for everyone. I don't mind having Lyrium Potions on the mages, but... honestly, most of the times you could just wait through it. But regeneration potions can be very useful. And yeah, look, we used a lot of Elfroot, that because... that's like 5 for each person, there's 4 of us, so that's like 20 right there.
Let me know if you need anything.
Besides, potions, healing potion. Yeah, that's gonna cost me a bit. I could probably get that if I really wanted to. That, not so much. Anyway. Let's end this fairy wolf going back to the war room. Okay, so summon the war council.
Wee.
Starts at like 4 bloody a.m. here, but oh well. Okay, so let's check on things. So we've gotten, not much gold.
What have your ears heard, Leliana? Anything new we don't already know about?
No, nothing.
Commander Corona, am I to understand you are in charge of the soldiers trampling on my lawns, providing food and refuge to the scrap of filth burrowing into my land? Plague on you, sir, for spitting in my face of a... face of an honest petitioner for taking advantage of my distress. Did my wretched neighbor Bantreff whisper in your ear? Tell me what he paid you so that you can at least know the price of treachery, sir. My consolation is that a few of the rank and file have gone to join your force of an Inquisition. And we're gaining some influence, but yeah. Black Imperium, though. The ship has been secured. Be wary of what you may find in the Black Imperium. No, that's not the one I want. Click up here. There we go. My dear Liriana, your offer friend is truly a mystery. Your search uncovered only a string of foreign accounts. The trail of coin led from Antifa to Deventer to the Free Marchers and Orlais. Someone hit the tracks well, but not well enough. Your warriors in Kirkwall, and remember, you owe me a favor. So, we gained an army of power for Farrakh, which gives him a free skill point. In the early days of Dragon Age Inquisition, there was a way to basically get a bunch of skill, those amulets of power, so you could basically gain experience points quite fast. But they removed most of the ways of gaining amulets of power, which sort of sucks, but meh. Meh, whatever. Who do I want to send? Yeah, send Josephine.
Let's see what we have.
Power is basically how you advance things on the board. You can gain from doing those supply things and others and... yeah. Anyway. Adar, I heard you were dead, and then a prisoner, and then maybe you fell out of the fate and landed on your head and forgot who you were. Seriously, stop that. We still haven't been paid. Some of our kiff made out of that giant shithole full of demons after the explosion. The rest are dead or missing. I don't know how many were rounded up by angry humans. If you're not dead and you remember who you are, help me find our brothers and sisters. Shukar. P.S. You forgot who you are. I'll remind you. Your name is Adar. You're Vashoff. You didn't get paid for being blown up. P.P.S. If you're dead, disregard this message. And we'll send Colin on this.
To work?
Now then, here's the thing with basically Dragon Age Inquisition. So if I go over here to my... you can't actually see this on the video, but if I go to my adjust day and time thing, once it pops up, so I go to change day and time. And let's say I move it up to 4 o'clock. And click OK. And then, well, you know, things are completed. That's an amulet of power for me, probably. And don't, I guess you aren't dead because some of our kiff came back, scarred by a bunch of guys wearing peri eyeball armor. Humans are strange. You still haven't been paid, though. P.S. Try not to die. You still owe me a plate. And I'm being messaged. Again. Yay. Yay for messages. Except for the game's now starting to lag. Well, my computer's starting to lag. Fun times. Where's the gold? Better money yet. The Inquisition Emissaries were a welcome addition to our vigil. The token my thanks I've sent in for outing arms for your troops. May the Maker grant you never need them. It's probably not even that good of a thing, but oh well. So yeah, that's pretty much how you do that. You just basically adjust day and time to whatever, to the numbers necessary. And yeah. Fun times. Huzzah. So yeah, you could basically do that to gain money just constantly. Like, an hour. Then you just go, oop, change. Collect the gold. Go, oop. Collect the gold. But honestly, that's going to take you quite a while doing that. By the way, in the next video, we will go to the hinterland and actually begin doing stuff. So, hope you all enjoyed. Thank you all, and have a nice day.